Did you know that there are hidden modules in Make that you don't need an account for? Today, I will show you 6 useful modules in Make that you don't need an account for. Hey, my name is Manuel and I'm the founder of Techflow.ai and we love automation. Today, I want to show you 6 useful modules that you don't need an account for in Make. So let's get started with the very first one. The first one is the archive module. So the archive module allows you to create an archive. You can zip it or you can also use a tar format. Or you can also extract an archive to access the individual files. We've prepared a sample use case for you here. So in a Google Drive, we have multiple files and we want to combine them into one zip archive folder. And then we are uploading it into our output folder over here. And we also want to extract that archive again. So if a zip file is coming in, we want to extract it and then upload the individual files back to Google Drive. So let us run this once and check the output. So first we are watching the files, the 2 files in here. Then we are zipping it and uploading the file again to the output folder. Then we are extracting the archive for demonstration purposes and uploading the individual files that come out of this here individually and add it to the folder. So let's check the output. We now have the zip file by Make and we have the 2 individual files as a docx file because we actually set here the downloaded file type, because by default a Google document is converted into MS Word document and that's why it shows the docx extension now from the extracted file. We could have circumvented that by uploading the file and then turning on the advanced settings and saying yes to convert a file and then converting it back target Google file to Google document, and then it would turn back into a Google document over here and not be stored as a docx file. All right, that was the first module. Now let's look into the second one. That's actually Android or Apple. So I don't know if you knew that before, but you can send yourself push notifications. You can watch a button. So you can have a button inside an app on your phone where you can push it and then it would trigger a scenario. You can watch text messages, send SMS and so much other things like watch incoming calls and outgoing calls. You could track it and so on. And like whenever a call comes in, you could lock it. And whenever the call was completed, you can lock it again. And that way you could bill clients automatically based on their phone number, depending on the duration that they are talking to you on a phone. Or you can also scan it with a QR code scanner and do like scan products with it. So that's all possible with the Android app and also similar with the iPhone. So the Apple app. So here you have all the Apple modules available. Since I have an Android phone, I will demonstrate it with an Android. And like this is just a very simple automation here. A webhook's coming in, then we have like some sort of order stored in. I want to get a push notification on my Android phone with some details and a link. So when I click on the push notification, I want to be redirected somewhere. So let's check the setup quickly. So we have my phone connected here, then the title, new order arrived from the Google Sheet, then an ID item, click to open it, and then a URL where I want to be sent to if I click on that push notification. Let's check it in action. If I run this, I'm getting this notification on my phone. You can see it shows the order ID and it shows the details of this order. And now if I open that, it goes to this URL. So it searches it on Google and I directly open that URL. That works perfectly fine. And you can do all kinds of actions with it. For example, we're using it when someone in our community joins and introduces themselves. I'm getting a push notification to directly go to that post. And then I can welcome the new student personally. All right, let's jump into the third module I want to show you today that you don't need an account for. And that is the CSV module. So you can use these modules to create CSV files, but also to parse them and then process them individually. We have a sample JSON file, which is just like an array where we have name and email address. and then we are creating a CSV file based on that. So we are aggregating it. CSV, create CSV works like an aggregator, and we have the name and email address, and then we put a delimiter, which is comma in our case, and then a new line. And then the output looks like this. So we're getting this one here. We have the title columns, and then also this one's over here. If you want to create a custom structure for your CSV file, you need to use the Create CSV Advanced module, and then you can define a data structure, a specified data structure with custom column headers that you need, and then you can simply map it here. So let's say custom one, and then custom two, custom email two, let's make it custom name one and custom email two, and then give it a name. Maybe the structure is fine. And then I want to use the parse.json as source, and then here I can just map it from my original source, and now it will create a customized CSV file for me. So if I run this again now, it will look like this and has these headers now instead of the original ones, which were just, like in that case, name and email. And then the parse CSV, it basically splits up the CSV file again. The input, it can be any text input that is in a CSV format. And then you can select the delimiter, and then it will create or output them as individual bundles like so. So Manuel, and then Tony and Matt, and so on. So that was module number three. Let's jump into the next one, and that is for currency conversions. There is a module called currency, which allows you to convert an amount between two different currencies. And we've prepared a sample Google Sheet here with the amount of 100 in different currencies, and we want to convert it to yet another currency. And you can use any three-letter currency code for this for the conversion. And this is how our scenario looks like. We are searching this Google Sheet. We're getting out all the rows where the result does not exist yet. And then we are mapping the amount, the input currency, and the output currency. And the exchange rates are coming from the European Central Bank. And then we are writing back the amount in the output currency back into our Google Sheet, and we're using a function to get only two decimals out. So using the format number function, we'll format it. If you're not aware or familiar with the functions, check out the description below. We have a make function cheat sheet for you, where you get all the functions explained, how they work, and why they are so helpful. Use that as a cheat sheet to save a ton of operations. Now, if we run this and look into our Google Sheet, it will add the currency exchange rate between these currencies, and now you can make any calculation with it. And it will always have the most recent conversion rates. So you can see the amount is in that format, and you also have the exchange rate, so you can use both in your output. Now, if you like this video, hit the like button below and subscribe to our channel. Hit the bell so you get notified about new videos, because we're outputting a lot more tutorials just like that in order to help you succeed with no code automation on Make. Let's jump into the fifth module, which is the weather module. Yes, there is a free weather module where you don't need an account for. You can simply use it like get current weather or get daily weather forecast. And you just have to define whether you want to use a city or coordinates, and then define the city that you want to look at. And if you run this, it will output the current weather in Berlin, for example. So the temperature is 17 degrees Celsius, and you get a bunch of different details. And this one is coming from openweathermap.org. And yeah, then you can send yourself a daily report to via email that the weather currently is this and that, and that this is the sunrise time, sunset time, and so on. Or you can send it in Slack or wherever you want. So that is module number five. And now let's jump into module number six. And that's actually a very helpful one that most people don't know it actually exists. That is the phone number. The phone number module allows you to parse a phone number to get it into a standardized format, no matter how the user is inputting it. So we have a Google Sheet over here with different formats of phone numbers. So this is like a German standard with international prefix, then this is US standard. and we want to get out the actual standardized phone number that oftentimes an API requires or another system requires. Like oftentimes they require the plus to be in front of, and there's a standard for it. So what it requires as input is the phone number and the default country for parsing. So you can specify the default country for parsing if you are in the US, for example, and the majority of your phone numbers are coming from the US, then you should do it like this. And let's check the output. If we just do it like this, for the first number, it actually will automatically detect that it is DE because it has the plus 49 in front of it. And then that way, it automatically uses the correct format already, even though we defined US. But for our second one, it correctly identified it as US number because there was no country prefix and you had set the default country for parsing to US, and that way it got the right format for US in different formats. So we have the national format, we have the international format, and the standardized format in E164. So that is the most common one that is used by most systems, and that's probably the one that you should focus on as well if you're working with different APIs or different systems. And it also gives you the type if possible, like fixed line, this one over here, this one fixed line or mobile. Now let's write the data back. So if we update our Google Sheet accordingly, we are getting the details here in our standardized format. The international format is this one, and actually we want to use the E format, so I should add that in column G. So the number in E164 format, E164 format. So that's the standard format, and let's run it again to update it. And now we're getting the standardized format. In Google Sheets, the plus symbol at the start does not work properly because it will remove it from the Google Sheet because it thinks it is a formula. So the way that we can circumvent that to actually show the plus is adding the single quote before it, in front of it, that tells Google to use the raw value, and now it updates and includes the plus here. All right, I hope you like these 6 useful modules that you don't need an account for on Make and can use them in your automations to make your automations more powerful. Make sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel to get notified when we release new videos just like that. Thank you for watching.